was going to move in his house. Hallelujah. But that crowd warriors come to this altar, pray all night long until they get a breakthrough. You understand what I'm telling you? We're going to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Reformation is coming back to the house. This is a restoring spiritual gifts. Restoring the faith that was once delivered to the saints. I don't understand what you're telling me. And so it got to be a time. It got to be somebody. It's got to be a woman, a young woman, a man, or somebody just besides the pastor who pray and travail for you all. It's got to be somebody who don't mind taking time to come here and get on that altar and pray until God brings an answer. Until God brings in a soul. Hallelujah, somebody. It's got to be somebody who's not ashamed to come and to put your plates aside. Fast and pray a day or two. And let God heal you. Let God bring healing and rebuke all of this cancer and all of these diseases. Somebody has to be willing to yield yourself to the knowledge of God and to the wisdom of God to receive the gifts that will fall in the house again. Because your flesh is enmity between God. Your flesh has its own thoughts. Our flesh has its own ideas. I think we should do it a different way. It should be done this way all the time. That's the way they used to do it. But what I'm trying to tell you, your restoration is coming. And reformation is coming. That means it once was. And what was has to be what is. But God does not change. The same today. Yesterday and forever, and it'll always be gone. So how many women to set our own wills aside and let the divine will of God be done? It takes sacrifice. I get in Pensacola sometimes and we have prayer, and you were wondering, who is the pastor? Mm-hmm. So I'll be hollering, so I know they're looking at me like, "Pastor, you, Jesus! Oh, Jesus! I'm working." I don't do it all the time because I have to oversee. But there's sometimes when I get in there and I forget about that. My name, the pastor, Brother Williams, is here. And I let go, I touch him for the old and the new. I touch him for those who are coming. I touch him for the wandering spirits. I touch him for those who are lacking in sustenance for their lives. Hallelujah, somebody. I touch him for the demon possessed and for those who are oppressed in their spirit. I touch him for those whom nothing has been prepared. I touch him. I move myself aside. I let the glory of God be revealed. This vessel don't belong to you, no way. Take off the pride. Take off the pride. Take off you. I tell my saints there, my kids, I heard them saying, "I'm going to do me." Y'all know, I told y'all about that when I was sitting last night. I hate that. I'm seriously, don't ever let me hear you say it. Even if you say it, y'all say it somewhere else. Don't say it to me. "I'm going to do me." But that's where you are now. You're doing you. You did it. You did it. Yeah. You did you. And so now you're in a mess. So the Holy Ghost has to undo you. But when you let the Lord do it, oh God, we get to a glory place. See, how many want to be used by God? You know, we have to get ourselves out the way. I know I've been there. I've done that. It's not about how good you sing. It's nice to know that. Because you can get up and sound like I'm sounding now. No voice. You know, I've got on the road. Left here, we're singing. We're a singing family. We know how to sing. We know how to put together. We know what to do. We were taught how to sing. But when I got into the ministry of Jesus Christ, and singing was not just something we did for entertainment. Singing became a ministry. And when it became a ministry to me, I had to find myself regulating what I thought in myself. Sound good. How many of you are trying to say, Somebody, people see me under the table. Sinners. You know, I'm not crazy. I'm not a fool about that. But I'm, when the Lord comes, when Jesus comes, everything's all right. I feel my help. Because the Holy Ghost is here. And that's who's in charge. Somebody say, undo me, Jesus.
Undo me.
We're blessed in this hour. God is bringing us into a fruitful field. I'm grateful to the Lord for this ministry. So it's brought me to a place of understanding really who I am and what God wants of me. It took a long time. Like I said, I was trying to mix it to see how I could make it better. You know, maybe Prophet ought to do it this way sometimes. I can see where I can help him fix it. You know, fix some stuff a little bit different. Huh? Y'all look at Pastor. Pastor should have done it another way. If he had done it that way, see, it would have been a better way. Y'all know you do it. Don't smile at me happy now. I'll point you out. Huh? But I'm saying, when you come into the knowledge of Jesus, of God's will, it's a beautiful thing, saints, when you come to the understanding of God's will. And sometimes, even when you don't think it's right, you go with it. You pray and let God help you walk it through. And on the end of that journey, you see where it's working for you good. It came in handy. I know I can call Sister Denise because she's been there with us. But when you get out there by yourself and you're feeling for something, those very rebukes that you got from the prophet, then you say, oh, that's why he did that. I've been there. That's why he said it that way. And you come back and you have to use a very teachings that you receive. Right now? Bring it back in yourself and know that it was the hand of God on you all the time. Because he could see before and after. He knew that there was an ordination upon your life. He already knew that. And God knows that there's an ordination upon your life. Those of you tonight who call by the Lord. Sam, call by the Lord. You're not always accepted. You're not always the one that's preferred. See, sometimes you're not the preferred one, you know, among men. It's not always the one men